don't mean to brag, but I am pretty organized, especially when it comes to my digital files. Honestly, I feel like I couldn't not be organized because if it wasn't all perfectly arranged the way I wanted, I would be so stressed out. And so I've set up a lot of systems for the way that I organize things on my computer, on my hard drive, etc. And today in this video, I'll be sharing all of those with you. So I'll go over exactly how I organize files on my computer, on Google Drive, how I use my hard drive, Google Photos. I'll touch a little bit on email and other miscellaneous things like that. Obviously, there's no one perfect system. You have to find what works for you, but I hope that watching this helps you figure out what works for you. So I'm gonna go and get my computer. So my desktop and my downloads folder, I always try to keep empty just because it's kind of like an intermediate holding space. Everything that's in there should either go in the trash or end up in some other folder. The bulk of my files are in my documents folder, and my documents folder is basically kind of synced up with this hard drive that I have. So I'm gonna plug it in to show you. This is a WD Easy Store hard drive, and I'll link to the specific one that I have. I'm pretty sure it's 4 terabytes, which is plenty for my purposes. So basically my documents folder and my hard drive have almost the exact same folders. And every week when I do a little bit of backing up and organizing, I will take the files that I'm not currently working on for my documents and just back them up to the corresponding folder in my hard drive. So whenever people see this, they're always like, ooh, what's in the hidden folder? What's in the hidden folder is fonts and software installations and other stuff I don't need quick access to. So get your mind out of the gutter. My archive folder is for old things that I don't know where to put, but also don't want to delete. Okay, so now I'll tell you how the rest of the folders are organized. So the folders that I have for school and for different clubs that I do, those are all organized by year, so that's pretty simple. My video projects and then other photos folders are organized by the name of the project and then the date. Whenever I label files or folders by date, I go year, month, day, because then it actually organizes it in chronological order. If you put, for example, the month first, then you would get a jumble. My other footage folder is for videos that I take that aren't for my blog. I just don't want to have all these on Google Photos because you either have to sacrifice a lot of quality or use up a lot of storage space, so I keep them on my hard drive. I have a portraits folder, which is for senior portraits, family portraits, but also recently for my photography class. So those I will label by the date, the kind of shoot that it was, and then the person's name. Pretty simple. And then lastly, my blogging folder I have organized by months. So for example, February was last month, and then I have the date plus the name of the blog post or the video. And if I'm doing some kind of Instagram content where I'm not just like taking one photo on my phone, if I actually get my camera out and take a bunch of pictures, then I will put those into a folder and I label it the same way, but I also add IG at the beginning just so that when it's sorted alphabetically, they all end up in one spot. Okay, so that's basically everything about my computer. In a nutshell, I try to keep as little on my computer as I can because 250 gigabytes fills up surprisingly quickly, especially when your computer is kind of old like mine and somehow it just gets filled up with junk, I guess. I don't even know what is filling it up, but I keep running out of space. So basically, as soon as I'm done with the project, I try to move it onto my hard drive, but I don't delete it from my computer until I'm done with it because I learned that lesson the hard way last summer. I don't want to talk about it. Okay, moving on to Google Photos. Basically, I have 3 different accounts that I upload photos to. I have my personal Gmail, my blog email, and then a family account. I have a more detailed video on my weekly photo organizing routine. It's changed a little bit since then, but it's still basically the same. But briefly, every single week, I will upload photos from my phone and from whatever I have on my SD cards and my laptop, and I'll upload them to whichever accounts they belong on. Okay, next I'm gonna move on to Google Drive. So I did mention that I have a folder for school-related things on my hard drive, but I really don't use it a lot because most of what I do for school, I do on Google Drive. I like to make my folders different colors, not because it's related to the class in any way. There's no meaning behind the colors. I just think it looks more aesthetically pleasing when your Google Drive is colorful. And also, I think it helps me find the folders faster. It's like, even if you asked me, what color is your folder for AP Lit? I probably wouldn't be able to tell you off the top of my head, but I think when I open my Google Drive, I just like subconsciously know what color it is. I don't know, just a theory. So yeah, then once you click on a folder for any class, I just make documents, and if it's a bigger project, I make a folder. I have a folder where I put all of the other years of school that I went through because I don't want to delete those, but I also don't want to have them cluttering up like what I see when I open up Google Drive. I've got a personal folder for random things, and then I've got a separate folder for vacations because whenever my family goes on a trip, I am the one who is a little bit obsessive about planning and organizing and finding all the things that we have to do. So this is what I do. I like to make packing lists, Google Maps, etc. I'm also going to show you my blog Google Drive. drive. So in my hard drive, I showed you how I organize things by blog post and video. So that's where I store footage, photos, graphics that I design, things like that. But on Google Drive is where I do all of the wordy stuff. So again, I have a folder for every month. I just name it the title of the blog post. And then down here, I have some documents that I refer to pretty frequently. So I've got my content calendar, my content ideas, my spreadsheet where I keep track of statistics. I just wanted to touch briefly on a couple of things on my phone. One thing is that with my photos, I will upload them to Google Photos and then delete them about once a week, so I normally don't have a lot of photos and videos on my phone. As for Instagram photos, photos that I've edited and I know I'm gonna post eventually, I keep it all organized by using this app called whatever it's called. It is super helpful. Basically, it lets you plan out your Instagram feed. And so what I do is I just upload all of the photos that I plan to post. And then when I need to post a photo, I have all of the Instagram ready photos at my fingertips. Okay, like two or three more really quick things before I run out of daylight. Google Calendar is my preferred way to keep track of things that I have to go to. Basically, I have all of my events scheduled. I also have it loosely color-coded, and by loosely, I just mean that not everything has a color, not everything fits into a category. I do not use Google Calendar, though, for task planning. And that is what I use To-Do for. And I'm not even gonna go into how I use this because I have a whole video for how I use To-Do for weekly planning, daily planning, keeping track of grocery lists, literally everything that I need to keep my life together. So To-Do is a godsend and you should check out that video. Last but not least, when it comes to email, just wanted to mention that I do use labels. They're pretty simple though, so mainly I just label emails that are for different clubs that I do. I like to also color the labels because then it makes it much easier to find the email that you're looking for at a glance. I also have a habit that I try to keep up with. By the end of each day, I like to reach what I call inbox zero, which is just not having any unopened, unanswered messages. Some days it's harder than others, but that's just a good way to make sure that you're not procrastinating on responding to things and that you're just keeping on top of your inbox. So yeah, I think that's it. I'm just looking at my little planning sheet to see if I mentioned everything. I think the one piece of advice that I would like to end with is to not be afraid to adjust your system. As long as you're willing to change, I think you'll be able to find something that works for you. Something that is organized enough without being too overwhelming. So, thank you for watching this video. If you found it helpful, please like and subscribe. I would really appreciate it. I really haven't made talking videos like this in a while, and I'm looking forward to making more. So if there's any specific type of video that you're interested in that you would like for me to make, just let me know. And yeah, I'll see you next week. Bye. That wasn't a very enthusiastic bye. Bye!